graphing equations in slope-intercept form. So our slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. Now the m represents our slope, so we're using m to represent slope. That's been our rate of change up until now in our linear functions. And b represents our y-intercept, where the line of the graph crosses the y-axis. The x and the y represent an ordered pair on that line, and it actually represents every ordered pair on that line. There's an infinite amount of ordered pairs on a linear equation when we look at its graph. So this equation actually represents all of those ordered pairs. When we look at the line, that line represents all of those points that make an equation true. So we're going to work with this formula to start with our linear equations. I find slope-intercept form to be the friendliest equation to work with. It's pretty user-friendly. I kind of think of it as a plug-and-play equation. My y-intercept is sitting there. My slope is sitting right there. I can pull them out. I can plug them in. They're pretty friendly to work with. So this is kind of my go-to equation. It's the one I really use every day. I kind of consider it my t-shirt and jeans equation. It's the one I kind of like, I need something to work with. I'm going to go to slope-intercept form. All right, so let's take a look at how we're going to use this. Write an equation in slope-intercept form of the line with a slope of 1/4 and a y-intercept of -1. Then graph the equation. So I have a slope of 1/4 and I have a y-intercept of -1. So I'm going to plug those in to my equation. So I've got y equals mx plus b, y equals m, here goes my slope, times x, plus, and then I've got a -1 here, so I can just write it as -1. So again, there's the plug-and-play version of this equation. I just plug them in there. Let's graph this. I have a y-intercept of -1, so here's my -1 on my y-intercept. Again, when I'm giving someone equations, I can't tell them to go left or right until I tell them where to start. Same thing when we're graphing an equation. I need to know where to start before I can do my rise and my run. So I'm going to start at my y-intercept. Now I have a slope of 1/4, so I'm going to do a rise of 1 and a run of 4. I end up with another point on my line. I can graph the line that connects those two points. Remember, these two points are really just showing you the pattern of the line. Just because they're kind of larger doesn't make them any more special than any other point on this line. This line represents the infinite amount of points that makes this equation true. So there's the graph of our equation. Next one, we're going to be asked to graph 5x plus 4y equals 8. Now you may recognize the form of this equation. This is our standard form. And if you remember, standard form is very fancy, has a lot of rules. It's not as user-friendly. You can definitely use it to graph an equation, but you have to do a little bit of work first. Unlike our slope-intercept form where everything's sitting right there waiting for you, not so much with our standard form. So one way we can use standard form to graph an equation is to rewrite it in slope-intercept form, friendlier to work with. So I'm going to take my equation and I'm going to isolate my y so it looks like y equals mx plus b. So I'm going to subtract 5x from each side. And then I'm going to isolate the y by dividing by 4. Please remember that when we divide by 4, I need to divide every term by 4, not just the ones that are friendly. So on the left, I get y. Here I have -5/4. You'll see the -5 over the 4. It's a fraction. It's right there for you. -5/4 x. And then 8 divided by 4 gives me the 2. Please don't forget this 8. It needs to be divided by 4 also. So I come up with -5/4 x plus 2, which means my slope is -5/4, and my y-intercept is 2. So again, I'm going to graph this. I need to start with my y-intercept. I'm going to graph 2 on my coordinate plane, and then I'm going to use rise and run to find another point on the coordinate plane. I'm going to go -5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as my rise, and 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 as my run, and I come up with a point. Now, every now and then we come up with a weird graph where I can't get to that point on my graph. I could go the other way. -5/4 is the same thing as 5/-4. So I could start here and go up 5 and to the left 4. That would get me on the same line. I can do that either way. Either way, I end up with that negative line. So here's the graph of that equation. Same equation. The ordered pairs that make up this line here will work in that equation too because these are equivalent equations. All right, let's take a look at some other equations we can work with here. What? Y equals -3. So I'm hoping that you're looking at that equation and starting to panic because there's things missing from it. When we think about slope-intercept form, the y is isolated, check. But the x variable is missing. So hopefully when you see an equation like that where one of the variables is missing, when we're talking about graphing a two-variable equation, That should set off some red flashing lights for you. So this is one of those weird to graph equations, and we're going to come up with y. So you can think of this like it's in slope-intercept form. Since the y is isolated, it's y equals, well, we've got mx. This is not multiplied by x. It's just a constant, so that's going to be our b, our y-intercept. And we could think of this as plus a 0x. But we know 0 times x is 0, and 3 plus 0 is, a negative 3 plus 0 is negative 3, so why would we really write that? So we don't. But you can think about it like that if you want, if that helps you figure out what this equation looks like. Because that then tells me that the slope is 0, and a line with a 0 slope is horizontal. It has a y-intercept of negative 3, it's down here, and it's a horizontal line. Bam, you've graphed it. If that doesn't work for you, what you can think of, can I get that off there? What you can think of is the fact that this equation tells you about y, doesn't really seem to really care much about x. So I can make a quick table that gives me all my y values are negative 3, and x is whatever I feel like. I've got some ordered pairs here that I can graph now, and I end up with a horizontal line. Again, just as if I thought about it as plus 0x. Another way, if you realize that we're looking at one of these funky lines here, it's y equals negative 3. We only have two lines that are kind of have funky slopes like that, horizontal or vertical. And actually only one of them has a funky slope because my vertical line does not have a slope. It's undefined. So since there's only one line that can be written in slope-intercept form because it does have a slope, and it's one of those funky lines, it's got to be the horizontal since it can't be the vertical. So however you come at it, this line is going to be a horizontal line that crosses the y-axis at negative 3. All right, one more, last one. Write an equation in slope-intercept form for the graph of this line. So we're taking a look at this line here, and we're going to come up with an equation for it from our graph. So I see a couple things here. I see that this line crosses the y-axis at negative 3. All right, so I know I've got my equation. It's going to start to look like y equals, and I need to find my slope there, times x, but it crosses at negative 3. So it's y equals something times x minus 3. Now I need to find what the slope is. So I have a few more points that have been identified here. I'm going to do the rise over the run. So I've got a rise of 2 and a run of 1. I've got a rise of 2 and a run of 1. So 2 over 1 gives me a slope of 2. So the equation for this line is y equals 2x minus 3.